cast to the sea, while the choir of creation sings how he loves me. If I ever need proof there's a God up above, I'll just open my eyes and see love. And I've seen giants fall, mountains cast to the sea, while the choir of creation sings how he loves me. If I ever need proof there's a God up above, I'll just open my eyes and see love. Don't want you to fit inside of my box, break it open.
Happy Sunday. Happy Sunday. I'm not going to pull the preacher thing and make you do it again, but that did not really sound like much of a happy Sunday, right? And so, okay, you want me to do it again? All right. Happy Sunday.
Happy Sunday.
Man, that's it. God's day is an amazing day. We get to come together and celebrate his goodness, and that's exactly what we're going to do today, just like we did last week, just like we'll do next week. And I hope that you choose in between those times to live for him all of the time, all for Jesus, all the time. I'm glad. I want to welcome you to First Baptist Church. You noticed that some of you didn't get the memo. You're not wearing the same shirt as everybody else, but we'll let that slide. We'll let that slide today, but we want to welcome you today. Today is our Falls Creek Share Service. It will be an amazing time as you get to hear from students what God did for them at camp, and so that's going to be a really, really good time. In fact, this is one of the few times that you will hear from me today, because you won't hear from me much later. You get to hear someone new, and so it's going to be amazing there as well. So it's going to be a treat. Mr. Levi is going to share with us today after our students, and that's going to be amazing. And so there's just a couple of announcements that I want to share with you. Your bulletin says we're having church tonight for business meeting, and that we're having our children's ministry team meeting. We are not. This will be our only service for today. We will have our normal Wednesday and our normal next Sunday. You might be wondering, am I an official old person yet? And I am not. Paige has not delivered yet, but we're thinking that's going to happen late today or tomorrow. And so she won't show up. The little baby won't show up in the video. So sorry if you were like banking on that. She probably wishes he would. But it's going to be a great day. I want to welcome you to our church, and we're going to begin with prayer, and then we're going to continue on with our time as we celebrate Jesus. So let's pray. Dear Jesus, we do thank you for this day. God, we thank you that those who went lost have been found. God, we thank you for those who know you, have a desire to faithfully follow you, God, with all their heart, with all their soul, and with all their might. God, that they recognize that everyone is their neighbor, and they choose to love them as Jesus has loved them. And so, God, we do thank you for today, and it's in your name we pray. Amen. While Miss Stacy comes up, I'm going to ask our gentleman to come forward to take our offering.
Yeah, we'll take the offering.
Yeah. Okay. We get excited about what's coming next, and we forget what we're supposed to do before. Let's pray. Dear Jesus, we do thank you for how you've blessed us, God, and we just, with this offering, want to return that blessing as we seek to serve our community, to serve those in need. And so, God, we ask that this gift will be used to do just that, to help us to love our neighbors. And it's in Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
All right, while they're taking offering, I'm going to have Linda come up real quick. If there's only one complaint about camp, probably would be only one complaint that I can think of, it would be the way I do organization. And I keep Brian in the shadows all the time, in the dark, basically, like this. You know, I'm always adding something here, changing something there. But I'm telling you, he's quick. He's got quick feet because he can move. He gets it taken care of, and we adapt and adjust. But I had Linda come up. She's going to start our service. Man, without her, I just don't know if it'd be possible. But the only one that might have went hungry this week would only be one, and that'd be Randy. But if I was guessing, she probably had his meals prepared. If I know Linda, if you know Linda, she probably had him prepared every day, had him taken care of. But she took way good care of us. And Steph was her helper. But we're going to hear from Linda, and Stace did this real quick. We wanted to give you this, Linda. Stace started doing this week for kind of like random acts of kindness. When somebody did a good thing, a testimony, a devotion, if they got saved, whatever, for whatever reason, gave somebody a helping hand, then she passed these bracelets out and made an announcement. And it says, "He will love first." It has the initials on there. And that's what we should do, is love first. And that's what Linda always does down there. And so we thank you, Linda, for that.
Well, Jeremy had told the kids he wanted them every day, every night they wrote, you know, two spiritual things that stood out in that day and then a fun thing. The spiritual part for me, I enjoyed the service down in the whatever they call it. Tabernacle. But that guy was covering our Sunday school lessons, I mean, like a repeat every day, and they were really good. But what I got the most out of was our cabin, the devotionals. I absolutely could not believe how good these kids are at doing devotionals. I mean, they were inspiring. I think some of the kids were probably saved at that time, that's when God really spoke to them, was through what these kids were saying. And Landon, he gave an awesome devotional. And we got a couple of girls coming up. We need them up here singing specials. They did excellent. I was just in awe at what our kids can and did do at Falls Creek this year. There's so much potential there. Out of kids that came up that I would never have dreamed, we got in front of people and were testifying, and just they were just speaking. God was speaking through them, and that's what the spiritual part of Falls Creek this year was. It was in our cabin that it happened, and actually, the thing that I had the most fun at was also in our cabin, and it was playing Rubik's Cube with our college kids. And I'll have to add, I won. Thank you.
She didn't bother to tell you that she didn't tell them the rules until they'd already gotten started. But it has been a great week. We have had a lot of fun. And I had an opportunity while we were at camp to sing to the kids. And I told them I kind of struggled over what to sing because Jeremy asked me a while ago. And I really wanted to sing something that was up to date and new and fresh, and the kids might know it. But that's not what God had in mind for me. And it's also not what my husband had in mind either. So this song is an oldie. It is something that does really touch my heart. It is something that I hope the kids will remember. It's called If He Hung the Moon. And it is about all the things that God can do for us if we will just allow Him to. So I know that the world is here. Like at Falls Creek, it's great because it seems like we can hold back some of that worldliness and all the struggles, and we kind of take it away. We take their phones away, and they have a blast. But when you step back into life, it becomes difficult again, and all the struggles are right there at you. So you have to remember that if you will turn to Him and follow Him, He can do anything with you because He thinks you are special and He has a plan for you.
In the beginning, He was the Creator. Into existence He spoke of the heavenly blue, and with one mighty swoop of His hand, stars, He knew where they'd land. So if you think you're just drifting along, then I have good news. And if He hung the moon, I know He will help you. closest friend in life is pulling away. Though you have tried so hard and lost, there is still hope. Look to the cross. There you will see just how much the Savior today. And if he hung the moon, I know he will help you. And if he holds a sparrow in flight, he'll hold you too.
This is our family group. We all had family groups, and this is some of ours. They didn't, not all of them made it, and so I want to apologize to you guys because I'm a first-timer, and so they make the first-timers do this in front of everybody. And my first time back at Falls Creek since I went with Mountain View in 96, and going as a sponsor, it was excellent. I had a great time. The worship music there they have is phenomenal, and the worship music we had in the cabin was phenomenal as well. All of these young people were so respectful, and they were very helpful. And we had multiple counselors from just Falls Creek that would come in and just tell us that we had the best group, or that they were so respectful and they appreciated us. So I want you all to know that all of these kids are awesome. We each night we had a in-cabin devotional, and those all went really well. It's amazing the way that God put those together. No one was prompted to do any certain thing, and the theme was just all, it just all went together each night. It was really cool to see that, and you know, not only did Kelsey bring a devotional, but she also brought the party. Everybody, as in, you saw the lights in the video, that was a lot of fun. We had a lot of fun together, and our family group here, I enjoyed spending time with each and every one of these. They opened up. They allowed us to get into their lives. They allowed us to share with them and share with us. And so now I'm going to turn it over to Joey because he happens to be the youngest. So we're going youngest to oldest.
So my favorite thing about going to Falls Creek was is I really liked Jeremy's devotion and stuff. That really just hit in it. And all the singing, like the in-cabin after the night tabernacle and the family group, it just, I've never really had anything hit that hard, and it just really opened my mind and eyes.
My favorite part about Falls Creek was probably the singing, the devotions, and seeing everybody. I really liked Jeremy's and Landon's and Bentley's devotion the most, but I think one of my favorite things was probably the family groups and Tabernacle.
My name is Trigger, and my two favorite parts of Falls Creek were the family groups right here and Landon's devotion. It was really just spoke out to me, and it was good.
My name's Hannah, and my two favorite things about this week, one would be our family group. At nighttime, we go and we get in our circles, and I kind of just got to know everyone on a different level and hear about their walk with Christ and how God has worked in their life. And another thing would be Brigham's devotion. She talked about keep going in the direction that God's leading you in and not looking back at your past, like your old ways that you used to. And I think that's the hardest thing, is going to Falls Creek and being surrounded by God all the time and all the people, not distracted by the outside world, and then coming back into the world when everyone here that didn't go, and trying to stay on the right track. That'd probably be the hardest thing. You have to just keep doing the right thing and not going back. And I just wanted to say that it doesn't matter what you've done, it's never too late to give your life to Christ. And you have to hit rock bottom before realizing that Jesus is the rock at the bottom.
Hello, my name's LaRue. My favorite thing about this past week would be Cody's devotion and Landon's, and just the worship music at night.
All right, I'm Stephanie, and they let me be a family group leader. So thank you guys for being in our group. It was one of my highlights of the week, too. I just want to say thank you to the church family that wasn't with us. I helped Linda in the kitchen, and the cookies and the desserts, all of that was so helpful to us because we didn't have to worry about what the kids were going to snack on at night. So thank you for that. And then you guys sent money so these kids could get ices or whatever they were wanting. So all of that was just greatly appreciated. My spiritual highlight of the week was that I've gone to Falls Creek since I was in seventh grade and then as a sponsor. And some years it's all about salvations and your group has kids that come to Christ. But this group, most of them knew Jesus and had him in their heart. And our devotions at night, they were all kind of laying a foundation for things. So Stormy talked about being on a firm foundation, having Christ in your life. And then Cody talked about watering that seed of salvation and just doing that next thing after you've accepted him. And then Wednesday, Kelsey talked about how we've got to shine our light for others to see what we have. Thursday, Landon talked about you've got to be in line with what God wants for your life. And then Friday, Jeremy kind of wrapped it up with, we've got to remove the sin in our life to keep going. So one of the things we did in our small groups, we talked about what's one thing that you feel like God is needing you to change right now to improve that walk with him. So they just kind of shared with us. So as they're back home, support them, encourage them to stay involved in the youth group, whatever they need. Maybe they shared at home what their thing is, but just keep supporting them and keep loving on them because they're awesome.
Good job, guys. Good morning, everybody. It was a great week. And I know you see me asleep on the slide, but that's about all the sleep I got. We averaged about 4 hours sleep a night, walked many miles, and the only reason we were able to do that is because God gave us energy and strength to do it. We had three salvations at camp, so congratulations to the ones that got saved. I want to thank all you guys for your prayers and your cookies and the money and just everything that you guys do. We couldn't do it without you. Just the safety that we have. We took 45 kids, 24 girls. 24 girls is a lot. No drama. We have some good kids. You guys are doing good with them. I want to thank you parents for allowing your kids to go. I know some of you struggled with that, but because of that, you know, they were changed. And my favorite part is seeing the kids. I mean, I've got to go for a few years now, and just the growth in the kids and the changes that they're making, it's awesome to see. You know, we see many kids who are shy that you wouldn't even think could do it would get up and speak. Multiple people who sang, gave devotions. Bregan, her devotion was awesome. She has a gift. And just to see them be raw and vulnerable and just talk about, you know, things that they normally wouldn't, it's really special. A shout out to all the sponsors and the cooks, Miss Linda, Steph for all the work they do, Jeremy for all the work he does. Without him, it wouldn't be possible. He puts in a lot of effort. And we just want to thank you all. It was a lot of fun. I let Stormy and Stacy pick their bunks first, and I got stuck under all the young ones. So I had like Olivia and Karis and Adeline, all them by me. And I don't sleep well, but I didn't have any trouble sleeping, so that's a God thing too. It was a lot of fun, a lot of energy, but a lot of good things happened, and I'm just thankful that I'm able to be a part of it.
Hi, my name is Landry. One of my favorite parts of camp was Patty Lack. She didn't come with us, but she gave us these little Jesuses, and what they talked about was that you can find God anywhere in the most unexpected places, and we should just be thankful for that. And the preacher on Tuesday morning in Tabernacle, Tuesday night at Tabernacle, he said that God is in every place, in every space, at all times until the end of time, and that hit pretty hard. And my favorite part was family groups.
Hi, my name is Creed. My favorite part was probably Landon's devotion and Cody's devotion and running the 5K.
Hi, my name's Bentley. My first year going. My favorite thing was Cody's devotion and Tabernacle family group. And I got saved again. And I went fishing.
We had a lot that went fishing. And so, you know, as pastor, I'm just going to say it, you know, my favorite thing was the food. No, it was. The food was good, but our family group time was amazing. We were right outside our cabin, and in the courtyard in front of us, there is these planters, you know, where you can sit, and there's a mound where, you know, trees are. And our family group was right in front of a Southwest Oklahoma tree, a tree stump. And so we met around this tree stump and had the opportunity to share, where we talked about planting seeds and things being watered and bearing fruit in front of a tree stump. But, you know, our life without Jesus is a tree stump. But yet he is the one that gives us new life and allows that which has been dead to be made alive again to where it can bear fruit. And as pastor, one of the most amazing things that I got to experience this week was watching God work through the lives of our students, through the lives of our adults, and seeing how all of that giftedness, that fruit in their life, was able to be shared with everybody else. In fact, I could have slipped into the bushes and disappeared, and everything would have taken place just as it was supposed to. And that might sound like an odd thing to be excited about, but as a pastor, that's what you want to see. You want to see people using their giftedness for Jesus to do amazing things. While I was gone, my oldest daughter's car stopped working, and it was because of a dead battery. She went to Walmart, took her battery out, went inside. She was going to have them do it, but she didn't want to wait because it was going to take too long. And so she brought her battery back out to her car, put the battery in her car, started it, left, and went back home. And now as a dad, I would have loved to have been able to take care of that for her. But as a dad, man, the most amazing thing was she was able to do that herself because of what she had been taught and what she had learned. And that's what we saw at camp. We saw our adults and students do amazing things as God had done amazing things in their lives. And I'm looking forward to seeing how that's going to impact our church and our community.
My name is Cade, and I would say my favorite parts were probably Cody's devotion and Bregan's devotion and fishing.
There were lots of great things at camp. I'll talk more about that later in family group. But a lot of great music at camp. A lot of good, uplifting, fast, get you in the mood worship songs. This isn't one of them, but I'm going to try to just tell this story. It's just common people going through daily life. But for me, it's a reminder that we're not guaranteed another day. We never know when tragedy is going to hit. And we have influence on people. Sometimes we forget the business of life. We just kind of forget that we have influence on our kids, on our community, on our next generation, and sometimes just on people God puts in our path.
And a preacher riding on a midnight bus bound for Mexico. One was headed for vacation, one for higher education. Two of them were searching for lost souls. That driver never ever saw the stop sign. 18-wheelers can't stop on a dime. There are three wooden crosses on the right side of the highway. Why there's not four of them, heaven only knows. But I guess it's not what you take when you leave this world behind you. It's what you leave behind you. That farmer left to harvest a home and 80 acres, a faith and love for growing things in his young son's heart. And that teacher left her wisdom in the minds of lots of children. Do your best to give them all a better start. And that preacher with her, can't you see the promised land? Bloodstained Bible in that hooker's hand. There are three wooden crosses on the right side of the highway. Why there's not four of them, heaven only knows. I guess it's not what you take when you leave this world behind you. It's what you leave behind you when you go. That's a story that our preacher told last Sunday, as he held that blood-stained Bible up for all of us to see. He said, bless the farmer and the teacher and the preacher who gave this Bible to my mama, who read it to me. There are three wooden crosses on the right side of the highway. Why there's not four of them, now I guess we know. It's not what you take when you leave this world behind you. It's what you leave behind you when you go. There are three wooden crosses on the right side of the highway.
Thank you, Donnie. You're starting to get a little glimpse, just a little glimpse, previews of what we got down there. It was really good. This is my family group. They had a single parent. So sometimes, not sometimes, all the time, we need a mama. Sometimes I'm hard to love, an old bald-headed man. But we had a good time. It was good to get to know them. And they seen, you know, being a single parent, how sometimes you have a dysfunctional family. But it was good. We all come together. It was great to hear all their testimonies. Every one of them gave their testimony. I'm going to talk a little bit about camp as a whole, too, since we do, Kelsey and I do lead the youth after this. But, yes, it was good to have them all. You know, we didn't all go down there being a Christian, born again, having Christ in our life, not all of us. But one of my group here got to experience that, and we got to experience that with them. And that's always the best thing. But we took 45 students total. And when we went, there were only three that hadn't accepted Christ as their Lord and Savior. But we all came home a part of God's family, every one of them. And to be able to do that, you got to have God in the lead. God's got to be first. And to be able to be a leader and to lead out good, that's what some of your Sunday school lessons were on. You can't do it without support. Your lesson was on Moses, and he even had people holding him up, a couple of guys holding him up, supporting him, and this whole group. But it started here, and I want to give a shout-out to Jill real quick. I don't know where she's at, but she may be in the nursery. She's back in the nursery. Okay, maybe she can hear us. But we got a new church secretary, if you didn't know. We've had her for a little while. But as all these forms were coming in for the last couple of months, she was taking them, her and Brian, together, and they were inputting them in the computers, keeping me up to date, how many kids we had, how many males, how many females, the shirt sizes. There's a lot that goes in behind the scenes to get ready for camp, building up to camp, getting the sponsors in place, getting the kids that do devotions in place, coming up with these shirts. Kelsey and Jennifer did a great job doing that. And I say I'm a single parent. I want to shout out to Jennifer and Chris. Chris and Jennifer and Kelsey and I, we lead the youth out all year long. And we couldn't do it, Kelsey and I. We do the talking, they do the cooking, they do the whatever, supporting they need to do. And sometimes they do the talking as well. But they stayed home and worked and allowed us to go. And we're thankful for them too, and thankful for Kelsey for helping me out all the time. But the devotions were great. Stephanie gave a breakdown of the adult devotions that went on each night in the cabin. But man, these students, as Linda said, these students are not, and I told them this morning, these students right here are not the future of our church. We're all God's family now. They're all Christians. These students are the church. They're just the younger part of the church, and we're the older part of the church. But there's a good work that they're already doing, and they can make a huge impact. 45 students that come back claiming Christ, you know what they could do down there at that school, on the courts, on the fields, in the hallways. And I want to thank Landry and Karis, and we had a trio of girls that led out. Paisley was one of them, and a couple of them that aren't here, the Kearney girls, and they did the special the first night, but they did special music. Bragan did a special. As far as the kids singing, and that's what Linda was talking about. We need to get these kids up here, and they need to start singing. They are the church. Stormy did an outstanding special, and they're supposed to sing today too, but their voices are gone. Someday we're going to hear from them. I want to. But LaRue, she started us off the week. She did an outstanding devotion. LaRue did good. All of them did an outstanding devotion. Bentley did a good devotion. Trigger did a good devotion. And Bragan, she ended up the last day doing a devotion. My favorite part of camp, if I had to have a favorite part, was in cabin. All the devotions that went on, adult, kids, and then we had kids after these that would just step up and come up and share with the group or what was on their heart. And then we had a special guy that came in, and he did our morning music too to get them pumped up. And that was kind of special as well. But the in cabin, our nightly, when Donnie gets on the guitars, you'll hear in a minute, it just does something. God, and that something is God moving in and through that cabin. He was there before we got there, and he was very evident while we were there. And I'm probably leaving something out, but I'm telling you, these adults, they got it. Linda got the schedule of the cooking ready before we went. Stephanie helped her. They brought it together. But in the mornings, Donnie be in there cooking, Levi be in there cooking, Linda, she was busy a little bit one morning. It didn't make the slideshow, and I knew it wouldn't because she was in the lead in front of Brian, but I got the video to prove it. But she ran in the 5K. I didn't say she ran the entire 5K. She ran in the 5K, and she was in the lead in front of Kels, in front of Brian. And you got to see it. If you want to see it, I've got it. But so somebody else had to do some cooking that morning, and I'm just telling you, everybody played a part. Levi and Cody would go reserve seats for us. When you got 6,000 kids going into a tabernacle, you better go get some seats. And all churches do it. But they would go reserve the seats. There's little things people don't think about. Stacy and Donnie had to go every morning to see what our schedule was going to be for recreation after, what was going on, where we were at in the bracket, and what was available that week. I mean, that day, for each day to day. But there's something going on all the time. And every adult had responsibilities. And I don't know how those other cabins do it, and I don't think a lot of them do, because to hear them come and talk, like to me, and what was going on, and behavior problems, and a parent had to drive 3.5 hours from Texas to pick a kid up. What I think Stephanie Cody said it a while ago, these kids make it easy to be a leader. And kudos to you guys. You parents are doing an excellent job. And let's just come together. And I'll say this, and I'll be done, because we want to hear for the rest of them. What we experienced down there was revival. And the kids get to go over to Lugert and experience. We get to go experience it. You guys need to get to experience revival. We're going to have to do something here, because we need revival. Y'all need it. We need it. You're going to get to start it with Levi. But maybe we need to do a revival with some of our own. You hear Landon. You hear Kels's devotion. You hear him saying different ones are good. Cody's was outstanding. I don't know if he's ever spoken in front of a group. But I'm telling you, you didn't get to hear the devotion. And so maybe that's what we need to spread out. I don't know. Maybe that's God talking.
Hello, my name is McKaylin, and this is my first time going to Falls Creek. And it was everything that I expected and more. I just love being able to get closer with everyone and create better friendships. And my favorite part was being in this amazing family group. They are really the best people ever, and getting closer with them was one of my favorite parts. And the worship and singing was amazing. It was everything that you could ever imagine. And I want to thank Jeremy for inviting me, because it was really the best decision I made my whole week of summer. And Falls Creek just made me realize how precious every day is. And you never know when it's the last day. You have to always be appreciative of every day, because you never know when it's going to be your next day. And to love everyone by you, because you never know. And thank God every day, too. Every day is a blessing. It really is.
My name's Briley, and my favorite part about Falls Creek is always the environment down there. It's just everyone's always so nice to each other and always complimenting each other. But this year in particular, my favorite parts were Reagan's devotion, Landon's, and my mom Kelsey's. They just all really spoke to me, and they all tied into each other. And I'm just so happy for our salvations that we had, and I'm just so proud of everyone for going. And also, the silent disco was so good. So,
my name is Hunter, and my favorite things about this week was all the devotions. They all tied to like each other, and I thought that was amazing. And the boys, our nightly roll call was also top tier.
Hello, my name is Lyric. One of my favorite things was probably Jeremy's devotion. It like really touched my heart, opened my eyes. It talked about if you dabble in sin, if you get closer, you can get stuck in it. And I feel like we've all been in that kind of situation where you get stuck in sin too much, and then you are focused on other things and not God. But one really fun thing too was probably volleyball.
My name is Levi, and it was my first year going, so the first day and a half maybe, I kept my head down, just looked down. But, yeah, I'd say one of my favorites was the roll call, especially from Dallas. Him and, Pastor Brian or something. And then just fishing with Gunner and Bentley, trying to always fix his rod somewhere down the line. But I think my favorite day was Wednesday. I got saved that day. I didn't plan it. I just stood up. And then, the singing with that in the morning and then in the evenings were pretty nice too.
Hello, my name is Gabriel. And my favorite thing about Falls Creek was Friday night I accepted the call to ministry. And probably the music. The music that they had there was awesome. And I noticed that the first night, whenever Stormy did her devotion about building your life on Jesus and building your house on the rock, the next morning, they played Firm Foundation, and that was definitely God working together to deliver a message because he knew somebody there needed to know that.
Well, hello, my name is Levi. I don't know who has more fun at Falls Creek, me or them. I didn't go as a kid. That's another story in itself. But when I go to Falls Creek, I'm just as happy as they are. I probably act a fool more than I should, but I have fun. I celebrate. It's a good time every time. And I enjoy just getting to know the sponsors more, getting to dive deeper into that, and getting to know these kids. Striking bonds with them, you know, that are kingdom bonds. And it's just impactful. To me, this year, the favorite part, I would have to say, would just be, again, the in-cabin devotionals. I mean, you do not know how impactful this group is. I mean, they got it. And that's just the best way I know to describe it. I love each and every one of them. And what's so awesome is just I love each every one of them in a different way, not just an overarching of, oh, I love you. It's each one of them brings a dynamic that is just so powerful to this group. Thank you.
My name is Titus, and this was my first year, and I had fun. And my favorite parts were the devotions in the morning and the evening and having a good time and probably fishing.
Hi, my name's Wyatt, and my favorite part was the pastor's lesson on Jesus and the Samaritan woman. It really spoke to me, and I also really enjoyed going to Devil's Bathtub with Langston and Cade.
My name's Allie, and my favorite part would probably have to be the worship music. It was all really good, just the feeling of being in the tabernacle and all that stuff, and I love Jeremy's lesson, his devotion, and overall, it's just a really fun time.
Hi, my name is Riley, and some of my favorite parts were getting to listen to all the devotions. They were really good, and they really just were heartfelt, and getting to worship in the nights at Tabernacle and in the mornings with Davey, and I liked getting to hand out high fives with Landry to, like, all the people that walked by. And the food was really amazing. And I'm so grateful for this family group. And, yeah.
My name's Paisley, and my favorite part was probably Bregan's devotion and just getting to know this family group better and also winning 3v3 with Hallie and Josie.
My name's Ryder. My favorite part was probably the tabernacle, getting saved,
and probably just playing football.
My name's Stormy. I'm losing my voice, sorry. I just want to say thank you to everyone who allowed us to be able to take their children and get to love on them. I think that the best part for me was just really getting to see some of these kids just come out of their shell and allow God to give them the ability to step out of their comfort zone and just to continue to keep growing for Him. And just getting to meet some of these new kids that I haven't really got to spend time with, but just they really are amazing, and it really is awesome to just be a vessel of God's love and just pouring it out to these kids and just letting that overflow to them. I just appreciate it getting to do that, so thanks.
That was one of my favorite parts at Falls Creek. Of course, at Falls Creek, there's a few less of us. The kids always sound great. It's kind of hard to get in front of a crowd, so they were kind of holding back just a little bit right there. Still sounded good, but you could tell at the end they were bringing it on a little bit. A couple of high parts in there kind of make you giggle as you go. But in cabin, they were turning it loose, and they sounded great, and I just really like hearing the kids sing. So many good things at Falls Creek. I'd be here all day, so I'm not going to say very much. Let the kids tell you about it, but the week, just so many great things. Just gives you opportunity to focus, draw closer to God, draw closer to one another, learn more. Just get a lot of distractions of life out of the way. But we were busy. We did a lot. It went fast. And we didn't sleep that much. But it's a great week.
Hi, I'm Langston. My favorite part of Falls Creek was probably Jeremy's sermon. It kind of talked about how you shouldn't dabble in sin. You know, you should hang out with people that are going to better you in Christ. And, you know, you might only think, I'm just going to hang out with that person one day. But then you're hanging out with them every day, and you're doing what they're doing. You're sinning. And the only way to get out of sin is to ask Jesus Christ to come back into your heart. And I just think that everybody in here can do it. And you know, it might be hard to cut off those friends, but once you do it, it feels great. And also, I like going to the Devil's Bathtub with Wyatt and Caden.
Hello, my name's Rowdy, and some of my favorite things were Jeremy and Cody's devotions. They spoke to me a lot, and also I played in something called the Super Smash Bros. Tournament. It's where a bunch of Nintendo characters fight, and I placed top 4 out of 60 people, and it was just really fun.
Hi, my name is Bregan. This was my first year at Falls Creek. I really enjoyed Kelsey's message. She talked about being the light and that one light can light up a room, but if you get, you know, a whole group of people, you can really, really light up a room. And so I really enjoyed her message. And then I went to a devotion, a little breakout session for worship leading. I really enjoyed that. And then the silent disco on last night was really fun.
Hi, my name is Morgan. My favorite part was probably Cody's lesson and Bregan's. They really stood out to me. And then getting to know this family group and Langston's laugh.
Hi, my name is Baylor, and two of my favorite things from Falls Creek was Landon's devotion when he talked about when God tells you to do something, do it 100%. And then small groups, probably.
Hi, my name is Adeline, and my favorite parts about Falls Creek was probably Tabernacle and Kelsey's devotion.
And I'm Stacy. Man, this family group is a lot of fun. I know the rest of them were kind of looking at us sometimes a little bit funny because we were laughing like crazy. Langston and Rowdy keep us all laughing and rolling and all kinds of good stuff. We had a lot of fun. I've my daughter's going to a different church, and she actually had the experience of Falls Creek with them. And, you know, she noticed that the students really didn't do anything. It was all done by the youth leader, and everything was taken care of. But here, it is a body of people that we're all putting in, and these students, I don't know if they just volunteer and come up to Jeremy and say, hey, I'd like to do the devotion. But my guess is, that's probably not what happened. My guess is that Jeremy is asking them if they would like to do that. And he does such a good job at getting people to get out of their comfort zone and to really start their walk, their understanding of what God has planned for them. And so you really have to start it somewhere. And it's great that they're getting a chance, an opportunity to start as youth. And some of them are already discovering, this is what I'm about. This is what I can do, and this is what God wants me to do. And so I really appreciate Jeremy for spurring them on. And I also have to give shout out to the counselors too, because or the sponsors. It is like the body of Christ working in motion, because everyone is doing something all the time. Levi, man, he is a worker, and he works, and anything he sees that needs to be done, and he's doing it. And all of the sponsors are the same way. And then the kids see what's going on, and they help out just as much. So, man, there's so much more that's being learned at Falls Creek when we're all together like this. We just gain all kinds of great knowledge. So I just have enjoyed seeing all of that come together.
Levi's going to do our devotion just like the adults took turns up there. And this is what we do in the cabin that night when a student gets ready to do a devotion or an adult gets ready to do a devotion. We have somebody else pray over them. And a lot of times it was a student praying over a student. That's what we're going to do this morning. I'm going to pray over Levi. He's got all the time he needs, and he's going to take it, and he's going to bring the message. And then we're going to have an invitation at the end. Donnie's going to come and play. We're going to sing right there where we're at, and y'all join us, and we'll do an invitation. But let's pray. Dear Heavenly Father, I just come before you this morning. I thank you for this service thus far. I just pray that you would just continue to move in and through this place, dear Lord. I just pray that you would just move in through Levi. Give him the words, take his nerves away from him, dear Lord, and just speak what you have for us to hear this morning. I just pray that we'll take it and apply it to our lives. And we just thank you for this week, and thank you for how you blessed us. We ask these things in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Thank you.
In my preparation for this devotion, I went back and forth. Probably shouldn't say it, but I'm going to say it. I felt like I was wrestling with God at times. And just what to speak about, you know. I had a thought of what I wanted to tell y'all about. And God, one morning, just slapped me and was like, no, that's good, but that's not what I want them to hear. And so what he wants you to hear is, and I've had this confirmed to me in the past few weeks, very, very much so. And this morning, I received some news, devastating news, that even reconfirmed this, and it's relationship. Many make a decision to ask Jesus into their lives, and man, what a blessing that is. But so many fail to enter into a relationship with Jesus, so nothing changes in their lives. They continue to move forward in the sin and stuff that they're asking Jesus to forgive them of. That continues to go. They travel a road of devastation, littered with sin. This has to stop. When you come to know Jesus as your Savior, when you made that decision, you have to form a relationship with Him. Jesus is so much more than just a decision. Jesus is love. He is freedom. He is peace. Jesus is the only way, the only truth, and the only life. The only way to the Father, and the only way to heaven. A decision will get you out of hell, but a relationship will give you life. God wants us all to have life and have it to the full. In fact, Jesus died for this. The fullness of life only happens with a relationship. To establish a relationship, you got to choose to be in someone's company. Therefore, quiet time. I seen you, and I was so just humbled watching you guys go out every morning and have your quiet time. Don't let that end. You want to know how you bring Falls Creek back with you? How you bring that intensity back? It's quiet time. It's every day being with Him. I believe in practicing what you preach. Quiet time is a must for me. It's every day. it needs to be a must for you. You can't have a relationship with someone you don't know. Christianity is a love relationship. Jesus knows us. We need to know him. So begin your quiet time with prayer. Thank God for who he is. He is all-seeing, all-knowing, all-powerful, and everywhere present. Thank God for Jesus. Thank Jesus for dying for you and for the resurrection. Give God your request. Pray for others. Pray for yourself. Prayer is one of my favorite things in this world. Prayer is such a blessing to you, to others, and to God. God wants to hear from you. You can pray your heart out to God. He doesn't want you to hold back. Picture this. Jesus in heaven, seated at the right hand of the Father, Scripture tells us. Hearing our prayers, he knows you. He's listening so intently. He's saying, hey, right down here, this is my brother, my sister. They're praying. He's listening. And then he's relaying that to the Father. Man, what a picture. That's prayer. When you pray in your quiet time, speak audibly. This gives your prayers a voice. God has given you a voice. Use it. Keep a list of things, people that you need to be praying for. A prayer journal, perhaps, to guide you in your time of prayer. Pray strategically. Pray purposefully. Pray with confidence, knowing God hears you. Pray to God with an expectancy for him to move. God answers prayer, sometimes not in the timing or in the ways that we want. But when he's answering, it's perfect. It is the perfect answer in the perfect time. When you pray, speak clearly. Don't mumble around. Give God your respect and your full attention. Focus on your conversation. Prayer is a conversation, so be listening as well. End your prayer in Jesus' name. Always. It is by his sacrifice for you and his divine authority that we have prayer. And an amen gives your prayer a close. It shuts the conversation. Reading the Bible. After praying, go to God's word. Get still. Be quiet. Find a place of solitude to be alone with God. Prepare your heart for God's word. Read sequentially. Read units, not just paragraphs here and there. Read for context of what's going on, where you are reading from. Read with an open mind. Expect God to give you something. When you sit down at your Bible, have a pen and paper ready. God will give you something. Be ready to write it down. He will speak through the Scriptures. One of the most beautiful and attracting characteristics of the Bible, it will never get old or outdated. Scripture, the Bible, it is alive and it's active. What you read today will impact you different a year from now, 2 years from now. As your relationship with God grows, your time and his word and your understanding will also grow. Every answer to every question is found in the Word of God. There is absolutely no fallacy, no exaggeration. This is truth. This did, is, and is going to happen. Reading the Bible every day will give you purpose, alignment, direction, meaning. It will show you what love is, and how to love, how to be kind, and how to apply truth to your life. Maybe you're saying, I don't even know where to start. My suggestion, start in the Gospel of John, the New Testament, Matthew, Mark, Luke, John. Start there. And when you do, The pastor Adrian Rogers gives these questions to ask yourself as you read the Bible. If you have something to write with, take these down. This is a message for all of us. If you have something to write with, take this down. Number one, is there a command to obey? Is there a promise to claim? Is there a sin to avoid? Is there a lesson to learn? And number five, is there a new truth to carry with you? When you start in the Gospel of John, read a chapter, write down what God gives you as you ask these questions, and then close your time in prayer again. Ask God to help you apply His truth and to walk in that truth. I encourage all of you to have a quiet time every day, at least 30 minutes, preferably in the morning. Start your day off. That means getting up earlier and making God and your time with Him a priority. I can personally guarantee you, you will never forget it. Can you imagine having that truth start your day every day? And it is, it's sacrifice. You've got to choose to get up a little bit earlier to spend time with the Lord. But I promise He will bring order and blessing to your day. And why would we want to have quiet time with Jesus? Here's why. If you have your Bibles, Matthew chapter 11. In Matthew, Jesus gives one of the most beautiful invitations in all of Scripture. Starting in verse 28, He says, "Come to Me, all who are weary and burdened, and I will give you rest. Take My yoke upon you and learn from Me, for I am gentle and humble in heart, and you will find rest for your souls. For My yoke is easy and My burden is light." Man, is that not beautiful? He says, "Come to Me." Jesus is saying to anyone who is listening, are we not weary and heavy burdened? I mean, this world can beat us down. There is always pressure to do this or that, to act like this or that, to go along with this or that. It's a lot. Jesus knows that the struggle is real. He says, "I will give you rest." Jesus is offering what no one or nothing else can: rest. Jesus will give you identity, which is exactly what we all long for and try to claim in other things. Don't miss this. Jesus is a sure thing. You don't have to measure yourself against the consuming, always negative thoughts of the world. Jesus says, "Rest. I will show you love, all things we seek." He says, "Take My yoke upon you and learn from Me." A yoke was a harness put on the neck of an oxen to pull heavy loads. Do you feel harnessed to be everything for everyone, to do everything for everyone? Jesus says, "Take that yoke off. You're not meant to carry the load you're trying to alone. You need to allow Jesus to bear your load." He gives His life for you to know this truth. He says, "Learn from Me." Right there, Jesus is offering the relationship. It's not just a one-and-done decision. He says, "For I am gentle and humble in heart." We don't have to live in fear. By being gentle, Jesus says right there, the fear is gone. When you come to me, all fear is gone. I'll take it. Doesn't matter who you are, where you come from, what you have done, or any other excuse used to deny Jesus. He is for us all. He has his arms reached out. Come. He says you will find rest for your souls. Not only are our physical bodies tired and weary, but our souls are too. If you're on your phone all the time, what happens? Battery runs down, right? You have to plug in to the power source to charge your battery again. Jesus is our power source. Some of us have been running on our own battery life for a long time. Plug back into the source. He says, for my yoke is easy and my burden is light. With Jesus, the weight falls off. Going to Jesus every day in prayer and reading your Bible, you are recharged. Jesus will define your priorities. Jesus has done all the heavy lifting. Choose Jesus. Choose a relationship with Jesus. Make time for Jesus every day. He will not make time. You make time. You choose to have that time with him. The invitation is there. Jesus is waiting for you to make the decision. Enter into that relationship. Stop, listen to this, letting your past haunt your future. Leave it in the past where it belongs. Choose to walk with Jesus every day. Would everyone bow your heads and close your eyes? In just a moment, I'm going to pray. Before I do, can I ask you, look into yourself. What is God laying on your heart this morning? He is speaking. He is calling. Maybe it is salvation. Maybe it's a rededication. Maybe it's walking in baptism if you've never walked in that obedience. Maybe it is church membership to be a part of us. Would you step out and come forward? Commit to a relationship with Jesus. I'm calling you publicly to come forward and make whatever declaration it may be. Jesus says, if you won't acknowledge me publicly, I won't acknowledge you before my Father. This is the day. This is the time. Come forward. Make that relationship key. Step out. Be bold. Before I pray, I just want y'all to be silent for a minute. I'm going to be silent for a minute. Pray to yourself. Ask God to reveal to you what it is that you may need to get out. Come forward. Gracious Heavenly Father, we thank you for this time. You've told us in Scripture that where two or more gather in your name, that your presence will be there. Father, as we acknowledge your presence this morning, I ask, Father, for whoever you may be stirring in, whoever has something to lay at the cross, Father, that you would bring them forward. Help them to take that yoke off, to learn from you, and to come forward and establish that relationship, Father. God, we love you. We thank you. We praise you for this time. It is in your Son, Jesus' precious name, I pray. Amen. As Donnie prays, come forward. Y'all come forward. Y'all come forward. In my life, leave me, Lord. Take my life.
come forward.
Candidates for baptism will go ahead and come forward and get ready. You may go ahead and have a seat. I mean, I want to thank Levi for bringing God's truth this morning. I know it spoke to me, and I pray that it did for you as well. While we might not be having our public invitation, I want you to know that if you have questions about what it means to follow Jesus, or if you have questions about what it means to be a part of this church, which, by the way, is the most awesome Baptist church in town, because it's the only Baptist church in town. But you come find me. I'll be one of the last to leave. I'd be happy to be able to talk to you. Now, Jeremy made a comment about Miss Linda in running, and that was supposed to be in the video. It somehow got left out. But you know, you ask, you receive, things just kind of happen. I bet it's going to pop up on the screen here. Leading the way, that's Miss Linda for you. Well, we're going to get ready for baptism, and as soon as they're ready, we will continue on with that part of our service. Ryder, is it your story that Jesus saved you this week at camp? Did you hear me? He said yes. Like we said, everybody went down, but all of us came back found. Some were lost, but he was found. And so it's my privilege to baptize you in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Buried with him in baptism, raised to walk. All right, share your name with everybody. Gunner. This is Gunner. Gunner, is it your story to tell everybody that you are a Jesus person, that you ask him to save you?
Yes.
Yes. So it's our responsibility to help him grow in the Lord. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. Well, it's my privilege to baptize you in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Buried in baptism, raised to life. Story that Jesus has saved you from your sin.
Yes,
and he's ready to walk in the newness of life. It's my privilege to baptize you in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Buried in baptism, raised to walk. Today we've seen new life. Today we've seen rebirth. Today we've seen tree stumps become living trees to bear fruit and to make a difference for Jesus. You've got to witness that. God calls you to live that way also, to live all of life, all for Jesus. I want to ask you to stand to your feet. We are going to be dismissed. I'm glad that you came and shared in this special service with us. I want to remind you, we will not be having church this evening. But we'll be back on our regular schedule starting Wednesday, and we are going to be having a special event next Sunday night. We're going to be having an informational meeting on being a foster parent. If you have any desire or interest or questions about what it might mean to foster or to help those who do, we'll be doing that next week at 6 p.m. as a part of our evening service. And so I'm glad that you are here. You glad to be here?
Amen.
Amen. It's awesome to see God do great things. Cool thing about God is he wants to do great things in all life, whether they are young or whether they are old. And so let's go to the Lord in prayer, and then we'll be dismissed. Dear Jesus, we do thank you for this day. God, we